Okay, here goes nothing. This is the Stuck Movie Watching Vlogs. This is for the month of September 2012. Saw quite a bit of movies. A nice little variety. You know, some mainstream, some foreign, a little bit of obscurity in there. I saw a lot. So before I jump right into this, just gonna say that I didn't feel like gathering up my DVDs this month, because it's like incredibly hot and some of them are kind of hard to get to, so you know, either stare at me throughout the whole duration of this video, which I can't recommend, or do what any sane person would do, which I'm sure most of you do anyway, minimize this shit, open up another tab, and I don't know, look at flowers or something. But and this past month, two rather eventful things happened. One, I finished my video game movie challenge. It's done. I'm done. So happy with that. And two, I guess you could say I celebrated my 2-year anniversary on YouTube. I didn't do nothing for it. I only did a Q&A, and that was a disaster shooting that. I had to shoot it like 5 times. So anyway, I'm gonna jump right into this. The first two movies I saw in the same day. These were the final films for the video game movie challenge. And then I have Mortal Kombat Legacy, in which I watched sometime during this month. It's not in this list because it's not a movie, but the final two films I decided to watch in one day, they're both overgrown films, which means they're both shit. One is BloodRayne, the Third Reich, and two, In the Name of the King 2, Two Worlds. They're done by overgrown. I really don't think I had to go into detail with that, with any of those. I watched VHS. I thought it was a great horror film, very flawed, but very great. Like, highly entertaining. I watched it twice this past month. I should have done a review, but I got lazy. I watched a movie called Point Blank, which I'm looking at it through the list, and there's something really confusing here. I'll get to that in a little bit. Point Blank is a French thriller. Kind of hard to explain without giving anything away, but basically it's about a male nurse who's forced to break a criminal out of the hospital he works at, and he has to deliver him to a certain destination within a short amount of time. Excellent thriller, just really like fun and highly entertaining. Like, Point Blank is a film I highly recommend you watch. I saw a movie called Grave Encounters, which is a movie that's kind of shot in the style of Ghost Hunters, which it's exactly that. It's about a TV crew that they put on this Ghost Hunters type of show. They're a bunch of frauds, and what they actually end up doing is they end up going to a building that's actually haunted. So it's a really good thriller, independent, no known stars. It was shown at the Tribeca Film Festival, and there's a sequel coming out, so definitely a pretty good movie. I watched Courage Under Fire, which is the one with, I'm saying too much, it's with Denzel Washington and Meg Ryan. It's with Denzel Washington investigating whether or not Meg Ryan's character should get the Medal of Honor. Kind of a forgotten drama, but I think it's terrific. I've always enjoyed that movie, and I think it came out in 96, and it holds up really, really well. So if you haven't seen that, that's a good movie to see. I saw a movie called Shrink with Kevin Spacey, who plays a shrink. And he basically suffered a tragedy, so he kind of resorts to pot smoking and kind of questions whether or not he's capable of treating his patients. It also stars Kiki Palmer, who's a troubled teen, stop saying ah. It's live. I'm not gonna edit this, so. And I thought the story was gonna be just about that, but there's actually a variety of subplots, some of which I didn't care about. But it's a really good drama. I thought it was gonna be a comedy, but no, it's quite the serious drama. Kevin Spacey's terrific. It's a good film. I watched Lockout with Guy Pearce, sci-fi action movie. You know, for the most part, I found it entertaining. But it was kind of bad too. Weak storytelling, bad acting, aside from Guy Pearce. Some good effects, but some horrendous effects that looked up. They look like they were made from the idiots that made Ultraviolet. So, it's a very so-so movie. Now, here's a not-so-so movie. Here's a movie that just plain sucks. The Cold Light of Day. That's with Henry... What's his name? Henry Cavill. He's gonna be the new Superman. Lousy thriller. I did a review for that. And, I actually liked the review I did. So, if you can, check it out. Next movie I saw was Shinjuku Incident, which is with Jackie Chan. It came out a few years ago. He's basically an immigrant who, what does he do? He goes to Tokyo. He's an illegal immigrant. Actually, it deals with a lot of Chinese immigrating to Tokyo illegally. And what he does is he resorts to crime in order to take care of the ones that he loves. A very serious film for Jackie Chan. Kind of a mixed bag, because it was really good. It was great to see Jackie Chan do something different other than comedy and action. Put it this way, Jackie Chan's character doesn't even know how to fight. But it's a good drama. Trying to remember it. It's not that it's not memorable, it's just there's a lot involved in it, so I'm trying to think. It's really good, but there's some really bad stuff about it too. It gets too muddled, that's what it is. The story gets very muddled. So, but it was good. The next movie, I'm gonna break the number one rule. I shouldn't talk about this movie, but yep, it's Fight Club. I felt like watching it. I've actually had it on Blu-ray for the longest time. Finally got a chance to watch it on Blu-ray. I like that movie a whole lot more every time I watch it. Because to be honest, I didn't like it when it first came out. Because I didn't get it. I was an idiot. But it's a terrific movie. And the Blu-ray is fantastic. Alright, next movie I saw was... I hope I didn't skip any. No, I didn't. Next movie I saw was Safe with Jason Statham. I actually liked that movie. Very standard, nothing, you know, original, nothing great. Statham is Statham. He kicks ass. Kicks ass. I think at one time he takes off his shirt. Let's see. A lot of ass kicking, but actually a lot of gunplay. Very, surprised with the amount of gunplay and the body count. So it's a really highly violent movie. I enjoyed it. Glow. I have the DVD right there, but I don't want to reach it. I'll probably knock over the camera. Glow with Johnny Depp. I haven't seen it in such a long time. I just felt like watching it. In fact, starting with this movie, I guess I didn't. I was going to say I got into watching crime movies, but anyway, Glow, that's a great film. It's a great film. I think it's, I don't think it's underrated. I don't think it's overrated. I think it got the amount of praise it deserves. It's really good. Now, here's a movie I've had on DVD for a very long time. Really didn't want to watch it only because it is well over 4 hours. It's called Once Upon a Time in America, came out in 1984, stars Robert De Niro. It is Sergio Leone's last film. And I've seen the movie as a kid, but, you know, as a kid, who's going to remember a four-hour film? But, yeah, you know what? Great film. I think it drags at some points, but it's a really great film. Also has James Woods, very young Jennifer Connelly. I'm talking about like a teenage Jennifer Connelly. I watched the whole movie in one day. That's how I roll. Got nothing else to do. Cliffhanger, remember that one? Sylvester Stallone? Dude, on that day, it was so hot. I was like dying. So I put on Cliffhanger because there's a lot of snow in that movie. And I just imagined being in the snow, the avalanches and everything. I don't know what I'm talking about. But yeah, I've always liked Cliffhanger. Sylvester Stallone is pretty badass in there. Okay, this is why I said that looking at Point Blank was confusing, because I also watched, and I will show this one, Point Blank. See? I knew it was going to fuck that up. Point Blank. I am an FBI agent. Dude, I love this movie. I mean, it's a guy movie. It's so much fun. And I take great pleasure in knowing that the director of Point Blank won an Oscar sometime, you know, down the line. Catherine Bigelow, you may have, you know, captured everybody's attention with The Hurt Locker, but you captured my heart with Point Blank. Okay. Let's see, next movie I saw was Think Like a Man, which I really enjoyed. It's not the smartest movie out there, but I thought it was a really sweet comedy. I love Gabrielle Union and Megan Good, and to see them in one movie. Her name? Taraji P. Henson? She's cute too. Just a bunch of fine, fine women in that movie. I did enjoy the movie, though. I saw Big Miracle with John Krasinski, a.k.a. Jim from The Office, and Drew Barrymore, a.k.a. Chelsea Grossi. I actually liked that movie a lot. That is a really sweet family drama. Very, and it's based on a true story. Seriously, if you have a family, or if you just like good films, check that movie out. It was really good. It's about saving whales, so it's pretty epic. I saw a movie called Paranoid Park, which is a IFC film, independent as all hell. Gus Van Sant, is that how you say his name? He directed it, and I really thought it was going to be a good movie. That movie is shit. It's an art house film. It definitely has some commendable stuff about it. It's about a young teenage skater who accidentally kills a security guard, but he lies about it, or he keeps it a secret, and the guilt builds up inside. I really thought that sounded like an intriguing little story, but the movie just, it's so dull. There's like tons of useless shots of like this kid walking in high grass, and you know, just not my kind of movie. Love this movie. Something for Nothing, The Art of Rap, which is a documentary about hip-hop. It's directed by Ice-T. It is by far one of the best movies I've seen this year. I did a very enthusiastic review for that one. I even wrote a review for that one. That's how much I loved this movie. If you're a fan of hip-hop, you absolutely, positively have to see this movie. It is terrific, it is informative, it's actually funny, it's entertaining. Don't even get me started with this movie. I'm gonna move on, because I'll be here all day. I watched a movie called They Died With Their Boots On, which is from 1941. The movie is a big pile of bullshit. But, now, I know that sounds wrong, but you know what? The movie is actually very good. The reason why I say it's bullshit is because it's about General Custard, and they make him look like a hero who has never done anything wrong in his life. Except disobey orders. But he's a hero, and he's this larger-than-life character. Now, obviously, that's bullshit, but for a movie that came out in the 40s, for a movie that really intended to glamorize this character, and it got Earl Flynn to play him, you can't deny that it's actually a pretty good, dashing, and well-made movie. Earl Flynn is this larger-than-life presence. I liked it. I really did like it. But yeah, historically inaccurate as all hell. I saw Moonrise Kingdom, and I really highly enjoyed that. I'm pretty sure I'll review that one soon, but I did enjoy that. I watched People Like Us with Chris Pine. Elizabeth Banks. That should have hit me right there, because I love Elizabeth Banks. She was terrific in that movie. It's pretty much about, I'll look it up. I can't tell you. It's going to take too long. No, I'll tell you. Chris Pine returns home to, go to his father's funeral. He didn't like his father, and he finds out that he has to, give some money to the family, to the sister he never knew about. It's a good film. I liked it. Maybe some won't like it. Here's a movie I did not like because I, in all honesty, did not get it. I will admit, I did not get it. Cosmopolis. And I'm not even sure if I am saying that right. I did a review on it. It's not much of a review. It's just me complaining. I just did not get that movie. That movie made no fucking sense to me. And Robert Pattinson I hate looking at the guy. Here's a worse movie, though. It's called Freelancers, with 50 Cent, Forest Whitaker, and Robert De Niro. I don't know what it is with Robert De Niro. You know, I watched Once Upon a Time in America. That's a great film. And to see him make shit like this. Freelancers is as cliche as it can get. It's a police corrupt, police corruption drama. It's terrible. It's like a teenager wrote it. It is terrible, terrible, terrible. Now, here's a movie that is terrible, but I actually kind of liked. It's called El Gringo. Not to be confused with Get the Gringo with Mel Gibson. But this movie stars Scott Adkins, who's, Adkins? What? He's a kickboxer, I believe. And it's an independent movie. Kind of a Robert Rodriguez ripoff, because it really tries to be like Desperado. Kind of comedic, live action. I, for some reason, liked it. Not really by a lot. I wouldn't recommend it. But there's something fun about it. Dumb as all hell, but it's kind of fun. It just deals with a white guy who has to travel through a Mexican town. He's trying to get out of it, but of course, you know, he meets up with a bunch of bad people. Almost done. I watched a movie called Sound of My Voice, and that is a very hard movie to, one, recommend, two, I can't really talk about it, but it basically has to do with cults, you know, and it's a good film, but you want to talk about an unsatisfying ending, that's your movie. I saw Battleship. Check out my review if you want, because I really don't want to talk about that movie. Okay, fine. It's stupid. I saw a movie called A Tale of Two Sisters, which is a Korean horror film, psychological horror film, and the reason why I saw this is two reasons. One, because I've been wanting to see it for a long time. And two, I have a review of that coming up real soon that's going to be on the Reader Film channel. It is this, it's part of this horror project that we're doing, and I'll be doing that. I'm actually going to, I'll be doing that October 2nd. So be on the lookout for that one. Great. I'm not gonna talk about the movie. Silent House. Who was in that? Elizabeth Olsen. It's that one movie that's made to look like it's done in one take. It's okay. Commendable in some aspects, but the outcome of it was like, you did not just go there. So, okay. And then yesterday, which is the last day of September, I watched a movie called The Samaritan with Samuel L. Jackson. It's a movie that was made in Canada. It didn't really get released here. I think it's on DVD now, I'm not really sure. So you're probably wondering how I watched it. Yeah, it's on DVD somewhere. Yeah, it's kind of a throwaway movie. Nothing really great. Very standard crime drama. Sam Jackson's great in it. But other than that, and a very disturbing aspect to the movie, there's not much to really say. But I kind of liked it. And I finished off the day and the month with everyone's favorite Christian Bale movie, apparently, American Psycho. I don't really watch this movie that much, because even though I really like it, I don't deny that it's a terrific film and Christian Bale is excellent. I think it's a little overrated, but still, it is a great film. It's just not one of those movies I watch all the time. Alright, so that's it. I hope I didn't miss any, but then again, if I missed any, I guess it caused this video to be shorter. No, I didn't miss anything. Why am I scratching my tit on camera? And why can't I stop? Alright, this is getting disturbing. I'm sorry. Damn, I really gotta watch what I do when I'm filming the video. But anyway, that's it. Didn't really have anything else to say. So I guess I'll just end this now, because I'm sure this video is going to be long enough. Check out my Q&A video. You want to talk about a long video, that's a long video. As always, the titles that I read off are in the description, along with the ratings and the links, if I have any reviews available. And y'all have a good month. Here's to October, which, to be honest, is never a good month for me. But we'll see what 2012 has in store. And we'll see what movies I bring to you or I talk to you about next month. So, peace out and what's up?